New for you tonight at 5 o'clock. Okay, imagine staring down an armed gunman who had already opened fire on someone else. Well, that's what a College Hill store owner did last night. And today, he's not only talking about it, he's showing us the video of the shootout that followed. First tonight, though, we have just gotten our hands on the 911 calls that were just released.
I just shot two people right here.
Don't shoot me, bro.
TND drive-through 1979, Westmore Federal.
That was my boss. He got the guy trying to run. He's holding him hostage, or holding him right now.
News 5's Andrew Setters picks up the story from here.
The owner of the CND drive-thru did not want to go on camera after the shootout that took place inside his store last night, but he did let us see what surveillance cameras captured as all this unfolded.
The recording begins at the moment two masked men come running into the drive-thru just before 11 o'clock. They go up to the clerk, demand the cash, and force him to open the register. Take another look. Notice only the man in white on the right side of the screen is carrying a gun. The second guy in the dark jacket is just pointing his finger at the clerk. That clerk, James Edwards, is forced around the counter, and the man with the gun opens fire on him at point-blank range. Amazingly, that shot misses. Police swarmed the scene within minutes because the owner was already calling for help. Wesley Hahn was watching from his office. Here is what happened from his perspective. He ran from the back room, his phone in one hand, his gun in the other. After creeping through the store behind the racks of chips, he told the man who just shot at his clerk to freeze. What happens next happens in an instant. Wesley Hahn and the robber trade shots. The thief's shots explode beers and sodas, but otherwise miss. It's tough to tell from the video, but the owner's shots did not miss. This man, Michael Osier, was found a short distance away with gunshots to the leg, the arm, the chest, and the belly. And this is the second suspect, Zachary Herzog. Remember, he didn't have a gun. Hahn confronts him, hiding behind the counter, forces him to the ground at gunpoint, and literally sits on him until police arrive. Wesley Hahn bought this drive-thru in 1994 after the previous owner, Dennis Wilhide, was shot and killed during a robbery that was very similar to this one. He says he hasn't really had too many problems over the years, up until an attempted robbery about a year and a half ago that led to him putting in the surveillance video that caught all of this on tape. In College Hill, Andrew Setters, News 5.